be in the same spirit in order to be of one accord. And so, and next week we'll be one accord with each other. So today's title is One Accord in Prayer. And we're actually going to start by praying. And here's what we're going to do today. Our sister Carol, the doctors have given up. Our sister Carol, mankind has given up. There's only one way Carol will be healed at this point. And that's through God's grace.
That's right.
We talked about it yesterday morning at the men's group, and I shared that sometimes we need to intercede. And in 1 Timothy chapter 2, it speaks exactly of that. It talks about prayer of supplication, which we're going to touch on in a little bit. It talks about prayer of thanksgiving, but it also talks about prayer of intercession. And as we spoke about that, our dear brother Jeff Sprite has said that he's going to stand in the gap. He's going to intercede. He's going to be the conduit between the Lord and Carol, because Carol can't be here today. So Jeff, if you'll come forward. You guys know about our mercy seat. Our mercy seat we bring out only on occasion. And the mercy seat is not anything special other than the fact that you be obedient to take the seat. And when you're obedient to take the seat, God will hear your greatest cries. Listen, our cries are great today for Carol. Doctors have given up, and pretty much Carol has given up, to be honest with you. But she's tired, that's right. But we have a greater God. And what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to pray over Jeff to intercede for Carol. I'm going to anoint him with oil, because the scripture does tell us in Ephesians chapter 5 to do so. And we're going to pray over him. And anyone who wants to join me can come forward. As we pray over Jeff, we're praying for Carol. Now I will tell you this. My prayer for Carol is going to be exactly this. That God would heal her. And although we don't like to accept this sometimes, sometimes God healing her will be exactly by taking her home. You guys have heard me say that, you know, when I was on my deathbed, that I was in a win-win. See, right now, today, Carol's in a win-win. Because if the Lord takes her home, guess what? She won. If the Lord heals her here on earth, guess what? She wins. So as we go together, I'm going to try to sneak through you guys. I'm going to anoint Jeff an intercession for Carol, okay? I'm going to sneak around over by you if I can, Diane. I'll sneak right through you guys. Gracious Heavenly Father, we praise you and we thank you, Lord, because these are the days where you do your greatest work.
That's right.
The times where man has given up, the times where man has said, you know, there's no other things that can do. And times when they can't do it anyway.
Yep.
It's only through you, Lord. Mm-hmm. Only through you that this can happen. Father, we know that she's going to be healed either way.
Yes.
If you take her home, she's healed.
Yes.
If you keep her here, she's healed.
Yes.
But Lord, as Moses had prayed in intercession, as Abraham had prayed in intercession, we are going to pray in intercession, Lord, because our desire quite often can be your desire. Your desire should always be ours.
Yep.
So Father, we will accept if you take her home.
Yep.
But Lord, we ask that if you do, that it would be expedited, that she wouldn't linger on.
Yes.
She's persevered for a long time. She's maintained herself for a long time, Lord. And as Barbie said, she is tired. Lord, bless her this day. Bless her this day. Father, I pray that come tomorrow morning, we will hear one of two things. The Lord has healed her and took her home, or the doctor's going to say, man, we don't know what's going on. But she's been healed by the Lamb of God, by the Holy Spirit that we trust and believe in. Lord, you told us to trust and believe in you.
Yep.
Holy Spirit, we trust and believe in you. May our words be heard. as Abraham cried out, as Moses cried out, Lord, you had told us where two or more are gathered, that you would hear our cries. Our cries are this: heal our sister. And our greatest desire is that you would heal her physically, Lord. But Father, could be your will, shall your will be done.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, I believe in my heart that Moses changed your heart about his people.
Yes, God.
Abraham changed your heart about his people. Lord, if you were thinking about taking her home, were our prayers the same, that you would let her be.
Yeah.
Father, Jeff shared yesterday that he could see her in the kitchen cooking up breakfast. She has said that herself, that she would love the church to cook breakfast for the church. Lord, may this come to fruition. Lord, we're going to trust in you. We trust in you in all things, at all times. And Lord, may you anoint and bless this time.
Holy are you, Lord.
Yes. Yes. And we say all these things in Christ Jesus' holy name. And all his people said,
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Of her head to to the tips of her toes. Anoint her body right now, Lord.
Yep.
Father, as she goes for this seizure test, the doctors say, she's fine. She's fine. Lord, that you would anoint her body in such a way that we would see a great blessing. Father, I know, Lord God, I know without a shadow of a doubt, if that was to happen, Margaret would be shouting.
Yeah.
We praise you for that, Lord.
Yeah.
Father, we're praying, expecting great things. Expecting great things.
Yes,
Holy Spirit, come upon her.
Oh.
Touch your body. You are the healing power.
Yes.
The doctors aren't the healers. You are the healer.
Right.
Holy Spirit, may you dwell in her in such a way that all the sicknesses has to run away.
Yeah.
Has to run away.
Yeah.
I remember so much when I was sick and the grandson said, Papa, run away from that sickness. Run away from that COVID. And Lord, we're asking you for the same thing, that Margaret can run away from that sickness.
Yeah.
That she can run away from that COVID. Run away from her illnesses, Lord. Touch her. Anoint her. And Father, may we rejoice together in the good news of Jesus Christ. In all things, we give you the glory. In Christ Jesus' name we pray.
That's right.
And everyone said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We want a Lord's Prayer, man, right there.
All right. Well, you guys have just witnessed the beginning of my message today. So I got a little bit more to say, though.
Yeah.
I got a little bit more to say. So let's
not
rock
the nut.
There you go. Church.
Yeah.
And I challenge you to come and pray with us. Listen, there are so so many prayers that have been answered through Thursday night's prayer. Prayers that have been answered from Thursday night by Sunday morning. Some of them even by the next day. I can tell you, maybe I should have been recording them along the way. So a guy at work the other night asked me, he says, Randy, do you journal? I said, no. And Jeff said the same thing. Isn't that amazing? He used the same words. Hey, do you journal? I don't journal. I wish I did now at this point. Because I'd love to look back. I will tell you this. I have, Donna can attest to this. I have a briefcase at home. And inside that briefcase, I have letters and I have cards of people that have sent to me an encouragement. And sometimes when I'm feeling down, sometimes I'll go to the briefcase and I'll pull out a letter and I'll read it. You know why? Because it encourages me. I'm not a letter card sender. I'm not. That's not one of my gifts. I wish it was. I know that there are some people in here that are.
Yeah.
I know. And the fact of the matter is, when you send that card out and those people receive that, it's amazing. It's amazing. I won't mention any names, but I know three at least. Val, Jeannie, Diane.
Glad you didn't say anything.
But in doing so, truly, I know that there are a couple others that I probably missed. But listen to me. Hazel, you are so good about sending me letters on text. It's amazing when I open up my text and there's a letter from Hazel saying a word of encouragement. Listen to me. I don't do this a lot, but I'm going to plug our Facebook page. We record on Facebook and on YouTube every single Sunday. At this point, our church has 303 followers on Facebook, believe it or not. I know a lot of people that watch Facebook. I'm going to encourage you, if you have Facebook, to go to our Facebook page and just hit the message and put it on your Facebook page. You know why? Now it didn't only just go to 303, it went to all your friends too. Listen, if it makes a difference in one life, was it worth your time to pull up the Calvary Community Church Facebook and hit yes? And resend it? To share it? Please do that. It's not because of me. I don't care. Whoever's in this pulpit, please do that. Because the more people that see it, one, was worth it all.
That's right.
See, in Matthew 18, verses 19 and 20, he literally calls for us to pray in one accord. Pray together. But see, one of the things that I mentioned a few minutes ago is that we can't pray for one another if you don't share your needs with one another. Mm-hmm. And I know people are private. I know you're private. And sometimes people will call me and say, Pastor, can you pray for me? But don't put it on the prayer chain because I don't want it on the prayer chain. I accept that. But listen, as brothers and sisters, we need to have the desire to lift each other up in prayer. I thought it was so cool, David, that you shared that Shirley's second operation went better than the first. Praise the Lord. Right? Praise the Lord. But there's one thing that I know and I believe is this. As you guys shared the need that Shirley had, that she was having surgery on her eyes, that we were able to pray for Shirley and the second one went better. Because we prayed. I believe that. You guys know I don't believe in anything called coincidence. And time again, I see it time and time and time again where something happens and other people would call it coincidence and I'd say, somebody's Debbie. Debbie says it's God incidence, not coincidence. Maybe we should all call it that. This is God incidence, not a coincidence. See, because what happens here is God's telling us here. He says, hey, where you gather together, and you share with one another, and you pray for each other, great things will happen. But if you keep it in yourself, and you keep on looking at the Lord and say, Lord, why don't you help me? Why don't you help me? Don and I was just laughing the other night about the story about when the floods came. You guys, most of you guys have heard this story. Yep. We were just talking about it, weren't we, Don? The water started coming up. So the guy in the four-wheel drive, they jacked up four-wheel drive, pulls up, says, hey, get in. I'll save you. Now I'm waiting for the Lord to save me. Then the boat came because the waters were a little higher. And the boat came up and says, hey, get in, we'll save you. Now I'm waiting on the Lord. fish drowned in the flood, and they asked the Lord, Lord, why didn't you save me? He said, I sent three different people for you, you wouldn't listen. Right? Isn't that true?
Yeah.
Isn't that true? And that's so true in our life. But listen, we cannot pray for each other if we don't know the needs of each other. Don't be afraid to share your needs. Don't be afraid to share your needs. And I've told you time and again, if I don't answer the phone right away and speak with you, I will get back to you within the next day. There's a reason why. I've been told by pastor friends of mine, Randy, I don't know why you put your telephone number in the bulletin. There's a reason why. It's because I want you to call me. I want you to call me. It's funny because we ran into Sam Noble yesterday. Sam was interim pastor here for a little while.
Really?
And Donna said this to Sam, who she had just said, we just talked about Sam 15 minutes before we ran into Aldi's and ran into him. That was coincidence that we were talking about him 15 minutes prior. And one of the things that Sam said, because somebody called me and wanted the number of one of you guys. I said, no, I will not give you the number. If you'd like, I'll give you their number. But I'm not giving numbers up. I don't. And Donna says, and this is what Sam says, you can give anybody my number up. I'll be happy to speak with them. Then we ran into him all these 15, 20 minutes later, right after we talked about it. And Sam told us the same thing. But that was coincidence that we talked about it, and then Sam told us the exact same thing.
Coincidence.
Yeah, coincidence, right?
Oh, God.
God is. Wow. Listen, that's confirmation. That's what that is. And it's amazing how God confirms and confirms and confirms. And in doing so, again, he's telling us, listen, share with one another. Share with one another. We're called to do that. Acts 1, 13 and 14 says this, and when they had entered, they went up into the upper room where they were staying. Peter, James, John, and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, the son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot. Oh yeah, and Judas, the son of James. These, how many?
All.
These all continued with one accord in prayer. Listen, if God's apostles, if Christ's apostles could go in the upper room and pray together in one accord, why? Isn't that what we're called to do? Is to pray together in one accord? To be there for one another and pray together? It says, pray together in one accord in supplication with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. So there are a few extra in there besides the apostles. But listen, they gathered in the upper room. And their purpose for gathering up the room, upper room, was to pray with one another and for one another. Because they just lost their friend and Savior, Jesus Christ. They didn't even realize that it was their Savior yet. All they knew was that they lost their master. They didn't realize at that point that Jesus was going to raise. He was going to appear to them. They did. In fact, another verse tells us that they were a bit afraid. Guess what? If they're going to kill the master, maybe they'll come after the disciples too. And they did. You look, almost every one of the apostles lost their life to the Lord. Isn't that amazing? But it says there that they were together in one accord in prayer and supplication. And again, how many of them continued to pray? All of them together. They continued how? As we look at supplication, you guys know I love to do the Webster thing, okay? Here's the Webster's thing. This is the earthly definition of supplication. Ready? Let me read it for you. Earthly definition of supplication. The action of asking or begging for something earnestly and humbly. Earnestly and humbly. See, when Jeff sat in the chair this morning, he interceded for Carol.
Yeah.
When we prayed for Carol, we weren't praying for ourselves. Did any one of you, while we were praying for Carol, pray for yourself too?
Nope.
You did, that's okay. But we didn't, I don't think. Because why? Our focus, and Jeff shared that in the men's group yesterday, our focus was on Carol.
Right.
Our focus was on the Lord.
Right.
And what the Lord can do through Carol.
Yeah.
And then when Barbie's at an intercession for her husband, were we thinking of ourselves?
No.
We were praying and begging on behalf of someone else. But it says, okay, in supplication, you can pray on behalf of yourself. When Margaret took the chair, did we pray for ourselves?
No. We prayed directly for Margaret. Why?
Because the Lord wants us to pray supplications too. The Lord wants us, the Lord desires for us to say, hey, you know what, Lord? I need thee. I need thee. See, the thing with Carol is this. The doctors have pretty much given up. Everyone around her has pretty much given up. And to be quite honest with you, Carol, as far as life here on earth, has pretty much given up that she says she's not going to do any more preventive care. And Barbie said it perfectly. She's tired. But you know what? Unfortunately, Sue's not here today. But Sue's husband, who was an elder in our church, he called me that one Sunday and says, hey, you know, will you do my funeral? It rocked my world. What's going on? He says, I'm putting dialysis. Listen to me. The doctor said that he probably would die within 3 weeks, if not sooner. Maybe a couple months if he was lucky. Chuck lasted for 4 years and 2 months. Chuck had not urinated on his own in over 6 months. He stopped dialysis 3 days later and started urinating on his own. You think that was because of the doctor?
Nope.
There's no way. The doctor had nothing to do with that. The doctor had given up. The doctor says, Chuck, if you quit the dialysis, you are going to die. I'm sure that the same thing has happened with Carol. I'm sure the doctors have related to her. Carol, if you stop the preventative maintenance, you will die. Dorothy's a nurse. Dorothy, isn't that what typically happens? There's a reason why hospice is called in. Because hospice is the group that takes care of you until you die. Comforts you until you die. That's what hospice does. Sometimes it's a couple of days, and sometimes it's a couple of months, and sometimes it's a couple of years. That's what hospice's responsibility is to comfort you. It's not to prevent it. Listen, my God is greater. Remember, we talked about that three or four weeks ago? What did I say about each and every one of you? Do you guys remember? What did I say? What was it? You're great. Why are you great? Because the Holy Spirit is in you. And because God is greater, God makes each and every one of you that believe in Jesus Christ great. Start living like you're great. Start living like you're great. God's telling us this. He's saying, hey, listen, if you humble yourself and you pray earnestly, I will hear your cries. But there's two important things there. One is humbling yourself, which too often we can't. Our pride gets in the way. God said, put your pride away and come to me.
Yes.
And in doing so, if you come to me earnestly, what will happen? I will hear your cry. I will hear your prayer.
Yeah.
Open the door, and he shall come in. Open the door, and he'll hear. Acts 4:24 says this, so when they heard that, they raised their voices to God with one accord. Isn't that amazing? And said, Lord, you are God who made heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them. God is the God of all creation. How much creation?
All.
All, everything that's made here on earth is of God. Listen, somebody would say, well, God didn't make the boat. No, but God built that tree that they made the boat with. Because guess what? If you didn't have the tree, you probably wouldn't have the boat, would you?
Creation.
He's the God of creation. Listen, but the most important part is he's not the God of the creation of all things. He's the God of creation. You and I have been created by God. You You and I have been created by God. I didn't have this in my notes, but in Psalms 139, what does it say? He knows our innermost being. He knitted us. He knitted us in our mother's womb. You are awesomely and perfectly made. You are awesomely made by our great Creator God. Listen, when you pray, you better pray pray of thanksgiving. You better pray praising the Lord. There's a reason why in the Lord's Prayer He says, "Hallowed be thy name," is because we're supposed to glorify Him and glorify Him only. Before we come to Him with our needs, we should be glorifying Him first. Now, it doesn't say this is a Randyism, okay? You guys know Randyism says it's not directly in the book, but Randy believes this. I'm telling you right now, as you praise the Lord and praise the Lord and praise the Lord, and then you come to Him with your needs, that when you come to Him with your needs, He even has a little bit bigger ear. I believe that. I believe that. If you are coming to Him with a need, 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 and you never glorify Him, is He going to open up His ear to you? Maybe not. But if you come to Him in praise, and you come to Him in praise, and you give Him the glory, and then when you get healed, what do? You give Him the glory some more. Guess what? He's going to have His ear open to you even greater the next time.
Yeah.
I believe that from my heart. And nowhere in the Bible does it say that. Nowhere in the Bible does it say that. But you know what? It does say that He has a great ear for the righteous. It does say that. Be righteous. Part of being righteous is by glorifying Him first. I love it because Daryl says, I can't do anything on my own.
Yeah.
How many times have you heard Daryl say that? I can't do anything on my own.
Yeah.
But with God,
all things are possible.
All things are possible.
Praise the Lord.
Man. Guys, it burns deep in my soul that we get this. It does. It burns deep in my soul that we get this. It says in there, Lord, You are God. They should have had 3 exclamation points. When I make some kind of notes in my notes, the ones that I want to really emphasize, I don't put 1 exclamation point. I put 3. Why? Because I want to make sure that you guys really hear it. Right? So right behind that, where it says, You are God, they should have put 3 exclamation points right there. Because He is. He's our God.
Amen.
Right? And in doing so, He says that because we understand the magnitude of God's greatness, we can be healed. But until we understand the magnitude of God's greatness, I don't think we will be healed. As individuals, as a church, as a community, as a country, listen, if we want our country to change, we need to turn back to God.
Yeah.
And if we would turn back to God, God would make our country great again.
Yeah, let's go.
You know, it's not President Trump.
No.
He says, hey, I'm going to make the U.S. great again. There's only one way that the U.S. is going to be great again.
That's right.
And that's through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Through our Lord and Savior.
Holy.
It says He created all people and all things. Everything around us. Look around. Last week we had quite a few people. This week we have just as many or close to it. Why? Because you guys want and desire to hear the word of the Lord. You guys want and desire to come and worship together in song and listen. It's going to grow. It's going to grow. That seed, when it's planted in the ground, I love this analysis. Have you guys all have seen the size of a mustard seed? You guys seen how tiny a mustard seed is? If you drop it, you can't find it. If you put it in your palm, sometimes you got to search for it or rub your hand around it, right?
Yeah.
Have you guys ever seen the plant, the tree that a mustard seed produces? It can be enormous. From a simple mustard seed,
right?
It can be enormous.
Yep. Faith like that.
Amen. So in doing so, we need to look at God the Creator. Ephesians 6:18 says this. I don't know if I used this last week or not. I should have, if I didn't, right? And the very first part says, pray in the Spirit, right? It says, pray in the Spirit how many times?
All
times, right? Pray in the Spirit at all times with how many kinds of prayer?
All times.
All of your prayer. prayers and petitions. He didn't say, hey, you hold some back.
Nope.
He wants to hear it. You don't think that God doesn't know what's going on in your lives? You don't think that God doesn't know what's going on in your lives when you try to hide around the corner? You might be able to hide it from your spouse. You may be able to hide it from your children. You may be able to hide it from your coworkers. But guess what? You can't hide it from God. He knows.
Yeah.
But he wants to hear you say it because he already knows.
Yeah.
And then what happens is when you say it and you pray it, you become in one accord with him.
That's right.
And as you become in one accord with the Lord, what happens? Great things happen.
Yeah.
Why? Because God is greater than you are what?
No,
you're great. You're great. Because God put the Holy Spirit in you. The Holy Spirit lives in you, so you are great. And God is greater. It says, pray in the Spirit at all times with every kind of prayer and petition. To this end, stay alert with all perseverance in your prayers for all the saints. I don't ask this often, but I'm going to ask of this today to you. If you are not praying for your pastor, please do.
Yep.
Please do.
Yes, sir.
Start praying for your pastor. He needs it. He needs it. Now Satan attacks you guys. Attacks that lady there. Even greater. She attacks me. Even greater. He attacks your Sunday school teacher. Even greater.
Yeah.
He attacks your Sunday teacher. Wife, even greater, who leads our youth program. Pray for us. We need your prayers. We need your prayers. We need your strength. I think it's so important. He says to us, stay alert. Stay alert. Especially these days, right?
Yes.
Satan's trying so many ways, so many different directions to make us fall. Right? And what happens is that if we don't stay focused on God, right, Jeff?
Right.
If we don't stay focused on God, we will fall.
Yeah.
We will fall.
Yep.
And in doing so, Acts 6:4 says this, we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. You guys think that I just say, come Thursday night, just because I want to hear myself say it? Not at all. Listen, Tuesday morning from 10 to 12, there's church leaders from our church and there's church leaders from New Life Church together every Tuesday morning from 10 to 12. Sometimes 11:30, sometimes 12:30. You guys know how I'm probably closer to 12:30 than 11:30, right? But in doing so, every Tuesday morning that we possibly can gather together, we gather together. And we pray. We pray for each other. And we pray for our churches. We pray for our community. And we even pray for our president. Because we need to pray for our president.
Yeah.
But in doing so, it's important for us to understand this. That the reason why we gather together to pray is because we want to draw nearer and nearer and nearer to our Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
And in doing so, Steve a couple weeks ago, or last week, laughed and teased about Pastor gets fired up sometimes on Tuesday mornings. I don't do it a lot on Sundays, once in a while, a little bit. But in doing so, truly, if you want to be blessed, come to Tuesday morning, come to Thursday night, come and pray with us. Sometimes it's more fellowship, sometimes it's more preaching and praying. It's okay. I know one thing, I know that the Lord will be pleased with each and every one of us as we gather together in his name. He tells us to. He tells us to. It says we will give ourselves continually. How often? Continually. To prayer. Continually. Then the last part it says, listen to this, and to the ministry of the word. You guys, again, I'm going to share this, and you guys know what the answers are, and you guys have heard it 100 times from me. I'm going to say it again. When somebody comes to me and says that they don't need church in order to be a Christian, you're right. come to church and be in fellowship with your brothers and sisters and lift them up in prayer and be lifted up in prayer and be in unison in word and be in unison in song, guess what? I don't know about you guys, but it makes my week a lot easier.
Amen.
It makes my week a lot easier. When you miss the week, that's hard. I need your encouragement. I need your love. I need your prayers. And I hope that each and every one of you need each other and need me. My prayer is that it says there that this is a ministry in the Word. Ministry in the Word. Every Sunday morning you come and I'm going to give you the Word of God. And I told you this time and again also is this. The day and time that I stop giving you the Word of God, you need to do what?
So.
Be gone. You're exactly right. Be gone. Get rid of me. Kick me out as fast as you can. Because it's only on the Word of God that I stand. Only on the Word of God.
Amen.
Let me finish with this. Psalm 119:11 says this. I have stored up your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. You hear that?
Mm-hmm.
I have stored up your word in my heart that I might not sin against you, Lord. Shouldn't that be all our prayers?
Yes.
There's more to it than simple. Yeah, we can make it as simple as we want. Yeah, all you have to do is confess with your tongue and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is your Lord. A lot of people think, okay, I will. There are some churches that even teach that. If you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you believe that in your heart, okay, you're done. That isn't what the Word says. Not even close. It says exactly the opposite. I think it was Donna just the other day. I can't remember, but I believe it was my wife that said, you know what? No, it was our son. It was our son that said this. It said, you think that sometimes when you become a Christian that everything just goes easy and everything's fixed. But in reality, oftentimes it's just the opposite. Because Satan's attacking and Satan's attacking and Satan's attacking. But guess what? We can make it easier because we have the Lord on our side.
That's right.
We can make it easier because we can now put on the full armor of God.
That's right.
And
that's
as
right.
We put on the full armor of God, we're protected from his sword.
Amen.
We're protected from his spear, his fiery darts, it says we're protected from. But you know what the beautiful thing about the sword is? I'm way off my base, and I'm finishing though, is this. The sword is a double edge. You know why the sword is a double edge? Because on one side you can defend, right? You can defend Satan. You can defend his disciples, right? But guess what? You tell me, brother. You're preaching, little guy. But on the other side, look at him. Maybe he's trying to stay inside with you. Woo! Say amen, little guy. Say amen, right? And then on the other side, you got the defense. But then on the other side, you can attack. See, there's nothing in the Bible that says that we can't attack Satan back. In fact, God loves it when we attack Satan back and we put him in his place. So the sword is a double edge for that purpose. It's to defend, but it's also to fight back. See, we don't have to be weak kneed. We don't have to be a bunch of sissies because we're Christians. We can fight back. But we've got to fight back in the Word.
That's right.
Not in our own strength, in our own mind. Fight back in the Word. So listen to this in closing. You ready? Okay? We are called to pray in one accord. In one accord means in unison by sharing with one another. To do it earnestly. To do it humbly. By raising our voices to the God of all heavens and earth. Pray in the Spirit. Pray continually. Pray with perseverance. And to not only pray, but also be in the Word of God. That's a mouthful, isn't it? But you know what? We're all capable of doing it. So my prayer to you is this, that you will always be in one accord in prayer with each other. Shall we pray? Our gracious Heavenly Father, we praise you and thank you for your Word. Not my Word, but your Word. And it says, shall your Word be done. So, Lord, we get things so confused. We get things so misdirected. Lord, there may be someone here today that is just struggling. And then we've sing this closing song. We May they come forward. Lord, I'll pray with them. Thank you, friend. Lord, maybe someone here today has never opened the door of their heart to you. May today be the day. May the time be now. There's no greater time than now than this. So, Lord, as we stand together in just a moment, and we pray together, and we sing together, may our voices be loud. May we raise our voices to the heavens in song and in prayer. And all these things, we will do it for you and you only, to glorify you and you only. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. And all the people said,
Amen.
Let's stand together and sing, Shout for the Lord. What a great song.